just excited this week to welcome you to another powerful word on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. This is the second part of our series on entering into the rest of the Lord. We have established that this is a divine imperative. God is determined that some of us will enter into His rest, that we will learn to live stress-free, filled with trust and faith in the Lord our God. We will continue to explore this mystery this week, and I'm excited about all the revelation that the Lord will give to us. Let us look at the word once again in Hebrews chapter 4. It says, God's promise of entering His rest still stands, so we ought to tremble with fear that some of you might fail to experience it. For the gospel was preached to them as well as unto us, but the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. And now we further into verse 3. For we which have believed do enter into rest. Hallelujah. Beloved, that simplifies the whole equation. Those of us that believe, mark the words, do enter into rest. You see, if I say that I enter into something, that tells me that there is a door, there is an accessibility, it is a realm, it is a level, it is an understanding, it is a coming of age. We enter into rest. We access this place where there is peace, tranquility in God, not in circumstance. I remember years ago, artists were given the task of painting a picture of perfect rest. Perfect peace, that is. And there were so many gorgeous entries. People painted snow-peaked mountains, and others painted placid lakes and gorgeous orchards, and on and on. None of them won. This is the entry that won that competition. The artist drew a tree limb that fell across a cascading waterfall with all that clash and turbulence, raging waves. And in the crevice of one of the tree limbs was a bird tucked away under the shelter of the limb, with all this chaos around it, with no care. That's it. That was the winning entry. That's real life. That's the rest of God. There's chaos all around me. Questions abound. Trouble in my life. But somewhere in the inner sanctum of my heart, I believe God. Wow! He says, if I believe, I find that realm. If I don't believe, I can claim that I believe all I want to. I can never find it. It's an entrance that I'm brought into because I believe. Ooh, the mind wrestles. The mind questions. The mind agitates. The mind is reaching to analyze and sort it out and get an answer and a solution. But to no avail. I remember once, it's in my book, the Holy Spirit said, the mind has not been given you to solve spiritual problems. You can't solve God. You can't analyze God with your mind. Come on, tell me, how did God begin? See, you just got stuck. You can't even get off the starting line. Then don't worry about these things. The question you ought to answer this morning is, do I believe? Do you believe the gospel that was preached to you? Do you believe the promise that he made you? Your feelings may be out of whack. Your mind may be out of whack. People may have turned against you. They may have deserted you. But God is faithful. If you believe him, you will enter into rest. If you doubt him, you will live a stressed-filled life. And you're going to make God angry. He will swear in his wrath. And I declare this morning, beloved, that will not be your portion, but that you will believe the word of the Lord and move forward from there to great victory and glory. In Jesus' name, amen. We love you. We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Yes, he is.